We find the glass everywhere in our life. Sometimes it is simple, transparent sheet, and sometimes it is hidden in the device. So glass ceramic plays an important role in electrochemical conversion devices. And one example of such a device is a sodium battery, because in sodium battery you should separate liquid sodium from the air, and for this you should use some hermetic sealant with insulating properties, and glass is an ideal material for that. Additionally, glass has a thermal expansion coefficient which is very close to alumina, which helps us to connect it together with metal or with the same alumina parts to seal the compartment where we have a liquid sodium. Now let us look in laboratories and in the future. So now we are working with solid electrolyte and high temperature batteries at temperatures of 300 degrees C. But in the future, we can use also crystallizing glasses. And the magic of crystallizing glass is that you can provide a phase which is ion conducting. And this sodium ion conducting phase gives us opportunity to make room temperature batteries with solid electrolyte. And for these batteries, we can even increase the energy density. You ask me how? It's very easy. You can simply use metallic anode. And here in this laboratory, we try to create this future, producing sodium conducting glasses.
The glass melting process begins with the mixing of all necessary raw materials. The oxides, carbonates or hydroxides are weighed in the right proportions and then will be intermediately mixed. The second step, the mixture of the raw materials, are pre-melted in a platinum crucible and heated by an inductive coil. This is necessary to compact all raw materials in order to get a sufficient amount of melt in the platinum crucible. For the next step, the preheated amount is transferred into a heated muffle furnace. Here, the glass is melted at the designated temperature and taken from the furnace after a sufficient soaking time. The glass melt is directly fritted into cold water in order to receive the glass thread, which is dried at 130 degrees C and then pre-milled to get a coarse powder which can be processed further. All the pre-milled powder is collected from the cup and then taken to the final milling process. With this process, we receive particle diameters around 100 to 200 microns. Hello everybody, welcome to the glass characterization laboratory. In this laboratory, the glass powders arrive and we begin with our characterization procedures. What we can make is a powder pressing powder compacts for the furnace processes. We can do light microscopy, optical dielectrometric measurements, and as well as some conductivity measurements and also measurement of mechanical performances. We're gonna start here. The glass powder arrives in this laboratory, usually after the milling process, like this, and then we're gonna start to make some powder compacts. The glass powder is weighed into the right proportion, which is used for preparing of the sample. After weighing, the glass powder is transferred into the mold, which is made of a hardened steel. We use an instrumented press for the pressing process, where we can record the force and the distance of the stamp. This is necessary in order to get an idea of the densification behavior of the powder. After the pressing process, we remove the powder compact from the mold and the sample is ready to be sintered. So after the preparation of the powder compacts, we can start with the measurements. For example, we will show you now the analysis of the softening, sintering and wetting behavior of a powder ceramic compact. So please follow me to the hot stage microscopy. Okay, here we see a hot stage microscope, which is an optical dilatometric method which allows us to observe and to analyze the sintering and softening behavior of glass powder compacts. For this purpose, we place a small powder compact on a substrate of interest. We close the furnace here inside, and then we heat the sample with a constant rate. And then the sample is enlightened and the camera photographs independent of the heating rate the sample continuously. And what we get here are a number of photographs which are digitalized and analyzed quantitatively, and from this data we can analyze the shrinkage and softening behavior, which gives us valuable information on the processing parameters for the individual glass powders. Here we see a vertical dilatometer which we use to measure the viscosity of glass powder compacts by the principle of the parallel plate viscosimetry. For this purpose, we place powder compacts in between here, and this plunger presses on the top of the powder compact. The powder compact is heated continuously again, and then the plunger goes down with a certain speed according to the viscosity of the glass, and from the resulting data we can deduct discrete values for the viscosity of the powder compact, and we can measure this property very precisely in the temperature range of interest. So, after sintering of glass powder compacts, we have here also the opportunity to measure the strength of the powder compacts by the three ball on ball method according to Professor Danzer here, by this arrangement on the press. After the basic characterization of the glass powders according to the sintering behavior, it has a compaction behavior, we have normally to prepare thin substrates to make batteries. So, and for making thin substrates, we're using a special shaping technology. It's called the tape casting. And for the reason, because the tape casters in the clean room, we all have to wear these clothes. The glass powder is transferred into an organic slurry and transferred into a container. The tape casting process works according to the Dr. blade principle. So the slurry is casted as a thin film onto a polymer carrier and transported along the tape casting device and dried. At the end, you can remove the casted film together with the carrier from a roll, and here you see that finally the casted film is removed from the coil and ready to be sintered. Because we need for our battery technology very dense sintered substrates, the sintering process is usually performed in a high vacuum. So the casted tapes are transferred onto ceramic substrates, which are very flat, and then transferred on the charging carrier of the furnace. And finally, after sintering of the green tapes, we receive from the furnace the final solid electrolyte substrate, which are now ready for the electrochemical characterization.